What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be looking at a 2002 Chevy Suburban two-wheel drive, because if you guys don't know, my OBS Chevy is a 4.3 liter V6, which sucks. Ever since I got the truck, I did want to transmission and motor swap it into a bigger engine, which is a V8. I did buy a donor to get some interior trims for it, like the dash and the door panels, but that donor had a blown head gasket on a 5.7, and it was a four-wheel drive, which I don't want. I want to keep this a two-wheel drive to have fun in it. I want to do some donuts. I want to do some fucking burnouts, throw this shit sideways, you know? Some cool POV drives in the future. So I just threw that shit away right when I parted it out. And someone did tell me to not 5.7 swap it, because there's no difference on power, to be honest, because it's a manual. This is a manual, so it'll just keep up with it. So I'm going with the 5.3 liter. I heard they're better because the timing chains don't break as fast as the 5.7s. And it's just an LS, you know, so it's better. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Like, comment, and subscribe. And stay tuned. All right, guys, so I guess I am recording. He just let me take the truck. That's the OBS right there. But yeah, he didn't come with. I was like, you want to come with? Or he just, yeah, he didn't want to. He just took a picture of my ID. Look at this clean ass. Dang, he got a 326 wing on that shit. What the fuck? That looks weird. But anyways, he said it has an oil leak. I kind of know where it might be coming from. I saw a hose. Well, not a hose. Something disconnected for the oil. So that might be where the oil leak is. But I'm just test driving it right now. And it sounds smooth. I'll go this way. I got to push it a bit too, just to make sure, you know. Because I will be for sure going fast in it. Okay, I don't know if it's supposed to be shifting like that. It kind of shifts a bit hard on from first to second. And the seat is like, I'm not that tall, guys. I'm not gonna lie. I did say I was like fucking 6 something in the previous video, but that's cap. That's cap. I'm 5'9, 5'10. I'm like 5'9, 5'10, but this dude, the seats don't even work. This shit is like, hold on. I might look fucking busted, but look. The seat is all slanted and shit. Driving smooth so far. I gotta give it some gas though, for sure. Make sure there's no cops though. Man, this thing is slow. What the fuck?
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Like, I'm flooring it and it does not rev down. You know what I mean? But it still goes up to speed and shit. How the fuck do I turn back? I'm about to waste this fool's gas. Goddamn. Oh my god, there's a fucking spider on me. Hold on. Look at this shit. Alright, I don't know where the fuck that spider went. It fell right back onto my lap. But anyways, let me see if I could move the seat up. Because fuck, these controls don't even work. What I'm doing right now is seeing if the transmission has power. Okay, Okay, that was nice. The pool's nice. Well, I'm gonna need to fill this shit up, bro. Fuck. I'm gonna do a whole U-turn real quick. It's got a Bluetooth stereo, but like I said, I'm only getting this for the transmission and the engine. It does have a quite a bit of miles, 204. Okay, it shifts. Damn. It's quicker than the fucking six cylinder, of course, but I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna see if I could get it for like 1,000. He has it up for 2K. I'm gonna try to be like, I gotta fix the windows. The windows don't go up or down. The brake cable is broken. It's all easy fixes. I think the fucking windows is the fuses. Also for the seat, it doesn't go up or down, you know? I was like, I was just asking him some random ass questions I was making up in my head. I was like, will this shit make it to California? I got a couple of friends and we're looking for a big ass SUV with space. So that's why I'm getting this, so. Oh shit, there's a bird. Get out of my way, bird. Fuck. All right, guys, I'm gonna just turn, go back to his house, and we'll see if I could bag this truck, you know? So catch y'all when I get home, maybe, or if I end up getting this thing. See y'all in a bit. All right, y'all. So look what we got. We got the fucking Suburban. He did not want to budge on the fucking price, man. I really wanted to do 1.5, but he did not do 1.5. So the truck was listed like at close to 3K, right? And then he dropped it down to 2K today. And then he was like, oh, I got hella people wanting it now because I dropped it down to 2K. So the lowest he would do is 1.8. And I was like 1.5, 1.6, 1.7. He didn't even want to do 1.7. So I was like, all right, fuck it, fuck. 1.8 it is. I test drove it, you guys saw a little bit. I kept flooring it because I was like, I gotta make sure the transmission is good. I gotta make sure this shit does not overheat or anything. So I'm about to go back home, see who could come with me to grab it. I hope my dad is there so he could drive it. And I don't know, 5.3s, I don't know why it felt so slow. I don't know. I hope I wasn't a dumbass and just wasted 1.8K on a garbage ass engine, because I'd be mad. So basically the plan is test drive it for like a month or two, and when I know it's all right, take the engine out, park the truck out, not this one, the Suburban, park it out, make some money back, and grab it. So that's the plan. Hopefully I make some good money back. We'll catch you guys when I get back home with the Suburban. So I'll just start recording when I'm home with the Suburban, show you guys around the truck. There's really nothing to look at. Obviously it's gonna be a donor, so just I really didn't care about the damage or anything. So if my dad says something like, yo, it's crashed, this, that, I'm like, bro, I just need the engine, all right? Because I know he's gonna say something about it and call it trash, but it is what it is. So catch you guys when I'm home. Alright guys, so I got someone that is able to come with me to pick up the Suburban. It's my boy Joaquin. Shout out Joaquin. Real one for coming with. So I'm gonna go pick him up real quick at his house, and then we're gonna go drive back like 50 minutes to pick up that shit box. So alright, so I'm tired as fuck, I'm not gonna lie. So before I go to my friend's house, I'm gonna get us some Black Rock. I got an empty, well, not empty, but got a drink here. It was actually pretty good. So I'm going to get us a drink real quick since he is coming with me. I got to get him something, you know. So I'm going to get him a drink, maybe some food if he wants. But I got to pay him back. Really, really thankful for this. She always grab people, snatch. It's usually my girlfriend, but she can't drive big ass trucks. So yeah, we got to get my homie fucking Joaquin. I'm going to get us a drink real quick and head out to his house and then pick up that shit box. All right, y'all. So we are in the Suburban. My boy Joaquin is in the Mamalona. Oh, yeah, I can't see. The fucking side mirror's fucked up. But anyways, we're about to go get some gas real quick and head out back home. Shout out Joaquin one more time. Long ass drive. It felt way longer than the first time I drove here. He even was like, dude, my Chevy looks fucking clean though. Look at that shit. I wish I could zoom in, but I can't. Hey, bro, look at this. I'm like laying down. Oh my god, this city is so fucking like. Oh shit, I'm going way too fast. My bad, my boy Joaquin all the way in the back. Shit, but look at me. I could be sleeping right now. Look. Bro, I just tried to put it up, right, the seat. And it just went more fucking back. I was like, no, what the fuck? But it doesn't go back up anymore, bro. Oh my god. But yeah, we're headed home, guys. We're headed home. It's got this Doubledin Pioneer Bluetooth stereo. 204,000 miles. It's driving very smooth, very quietly, as it should. Windows don't work. As you can see, only that one back there, but I'm not gonna put it down. Cold as fuck. And yeah, I really don't give a fuck about any of the cosmetic or anything about it body wise. Look, like cracked windshield, I don't give a fuck about that because I just need the engine, transmission. I don't know if I need the diff, maybe the diff, I don't know. But yeah, this is a 6 lug. My truck's a 5 lug, so I hope I don't need to diff. I'll probably will need to buy a new one, maybe, I don't know. I'll see you online. I'll do a little bit more research. But yeah, guys, sunroof works, heater and AC work. Good thing the AC works. I know if I want the AC to work on the OBS, I'm going to need to move the AC compressor to a different location on this engine. But I did find the kit for it to like move it up. It's very expensive, but I'm gonna get it because I really want AC. So yeah, nothing really much to show about the truck. No check engine light. Hopefully they didn't take the bulb out, but ABS light is on. But besides that, it drives really good. Hopefully I did not buy a fucked up truck with a messed up motor, because I don't know. I just don't feel the power it should have. I feel like I never really driven a 5.3 ever, so I really don't know how much it should be, you know, like feeling or how it should be feeling. So yeah, I'm kind of scared, but I am going to be rebuilding the engine. Not like crazy, you know. I'm gonna use maintenance gasket seals. I don't know if I said that already. High gasket, just to have this really good for the OBS, so I don't have to worry about anything. So yeah, I will catch you guys at home. Sorry, I'm not gonna do the swap in this video. This is just a start. I'm going to be driving this as a daily for a couple of months, maybe just a month, and then I'll take it to the shop, take the engine and transmission out of the harness, and part this thing out, like I said, and make some money back.
Smooth.
This is the first gear.
Yeah, it's like,
no, it feels like, I don't know if it's the fucking pedal or what the fuck is going on, but
hold up. It's like one or two.
It goes like this.
Yeah.
I know, it might be just me. The fucking seat and the pedal.
Bro, look at, I'm about to show the YouTube. Wow. Look how I was driving, chill, y'all. Chill. Look, just.
Bro, look at the fucking farm.
And this dude is. This dude walking is tall as fuck. He's taller than me, bro, and he can't even reach. Oh, shit. But yeah, this is.
Oh, and it puts traction off.
I don't even fucking know. Look. Oh, it does traction off?
It turns it off. You could probably burn down, bro.
Do it. You gonna blow the tranny?
No.
Alright, guys, that's the end of the video. If you guys know anything about LF swapping or OBS, please DM me on Instagram. I need someone's help, someone that knows how to do this. I just know that I am gonna need a wire harness for this thing, which I don't know where to get. If you guys know any place that sells wiring harnesses for a OBS to a 5.3 with the 4L60, please DM me, or a 4L80, because I do want to upgrade to that, because I am going to be hopefully turbocharging the engine, like maybe after I see how the truck drives. If everything goes well, I'm going to proceed to do a turbo on the truck, because I think it'll be pretty damn sick. And if you guys know any good turbo kits, let me know. I know there's gonna be a whole bunch of modification on the truck, just because that engine does not belong on that truck. So I'm probably gonna have to hammer some headers if I do end up getting headers. I don't know if I'm going to be needing a new diff. Maybe too much power will destroy the diff my truck has. If you guys know any good diffs that could handle a lot of power, please DM me on Instagram or just comment down below. Same for the wiring harness. Please, I need help. That's the only thing that's stopping me from actually doing this, and also finding a spot to do the swap. I've never done an engine swap. I've never taken an engine out. I've helped my dad take engines out, but I've never done it myself. So if you guys have any info, any important things I should know of, please DM me, please comment down below. And yeah, I don't know when I'm gonna do the swap. I've been having the Suburban for, like I said, 2-3 months. And it's just been sitting. The oil leak, I did find out where it was. I fixed that already. But I am going to be rebuilding the engine, like head gaskets, the gaskets, the oils, like fluids, you know. I am going to do a cam. I do want to do some type of cam. And if you guys know anyone that tunes these engines in Oregon, please comment down below. So it's just needing me saying I need a whole bunch of help with this, because this is going to be a big project for me. So. Like, comment, subscribe, stay tuned, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.